They say one shouldn't make assumptions, but I'm willing to bet that my audience here at Cityscape are sophisticated and intelligent people. So I want to ask you guys this question. What comes to your mind when you think of history? Those of you with a political inclination might think of the rise and decline of empires. The technocrats among us might think of scientific breakthroughs throughout the ages. Yet still, others with a more social viewpoint might think of movements in terms of human rights. While all of these are valid ways of looking at human evolution, few people think of prison when the word history comes to mind. The location of this episode is here to show that this deliberately forgotten corner of society has contributed greatly to not just New York City, but American culture in general. This is the story of Sing Sing Prison. Sing Sing is a maximum security prison located in Ossining, New York. Most people actually don't realize how close it is to the city. If you live in Brooklyn, for an example, Sing Sing is only an hour drive away. This close proximity to the Big Apple is an important feature of the prison's future development, as we will see later in this episode. But before we get into what the future holds, let's take a look at the past and see how this renowned place came to be. In 1797, New York City built its very first prison in a neighborhood we now know as Greenwich Village. The name of this correctional facility was Newgate Prison, and it was designed to hold 432 inmates. By 1821, however, the prison was holding 817 inmates, nearly twice its capacity. Newgate Prison could not handle New York City's growing population, so something had to be done. The New York legislature gave Elam Lenz, a former U.S. Army captain, the task of constructing a new modern prison. After some searching, Lenz chose a small village named Sing Sing as a location site for this new prison. The name Sing Sing comes from the Native American word Sing Sink, which means stone upon stone, or a stony place. This name actually hints as to why this was the location selected. You see, the area is called a stony place because it has a large quantity of limestone, also known as Sing Sing Marble. For a total cost of $20,100, the state acquired 130 acres at the village of Sing Sing in 1825. In May of that year, Captain Lenz transported 100 convicts from Auburn Prison to Sing Sing. When the prisoners arrived, however, there were no buildings to house them. That's right, the convicts would have to build their own prison. To construct their cell block, the prisoners excavated marble from a nearby quarry. Temporary shelters to house them from the elements were used in the meantime. Trained carpenters and builders were also there to direct labor. Construction of the first building took 3 years. The prisoners occupied the cells they had built on November 23, 1828. Now that the prisoners were properly incarcerated, Sing Sing would make its first mark in history by streamlining a prison methodology that would be known as the New York system. In the early 19th century, there were two penal philosophies competing for dominance, the Auburn system and the Pennsylvania system. Both of them have ecclesiastical roots. The Pennsylvania system drew heavily on monastery-style solitary confinement. Prisoners were to be alone at all times. This was to force them to constantly reflect on their crimes, while at the same time prevent a prison subculture from flourishing. Prisoners could see the chaplain, but not each other. Their time in prison would be a period of long, silent reflection. The Auburn system, on the other hand, allowed prisoners to work in groups during the day, but were kept in solitary confinement only at night. The Auburn system had a large Quaker influence. Its goal was to rehabilitate prisoners by teaching them strong work ethics, discipline, and respect for the property of others. Even though the prisoners worked in groups, a strict silence was enforced at all times. Prisoners would be flogged bloody if they broke this law of silence. Other notable elements of the Auburn system were striped uniforms and walking in lockstep. The striped uniform made prisoners immediately recognizable, so if a prisoner escaped, the public can easily distinguish them from the non-criminal population. As a kid, I used to see the Street Fighter character Cody wear a striped uniform, but had no idea it came from Sing Sing. Anyway, Captain Lenz adopted the Auburn system to run Sing Sing prison, so prisoners there worked in groups during the day and were solitary confined at night. The system was enforced by whipping and other brutal punishments, such as a naked cold shower bath. There's records of one Irish prisoner who was so brutalized by weekly floggings that he had forgotten how to use a knife and fork and could not stop walking in lockstep, even after being released from prison. One prisoner describes the lashing of a fellow inmate. It went as follows. Two guards were flogging the skin off the body, and the inmate was begging, crying, and twisting under the lacerating that tore the skin off his back. These lashing took place in a central hall so that the screaming from the inmate can be heard by other prisoners. The blood spill was also left there for others to see as a warning sign. Other interesting punishments were the iron cage. The prisoner was forced to keep a cage on his head 24 hours a day. This cage was a heavy burden during the day and a sleep depriver at night. Water torture was a favorite form of punishment because it did not disfigure the inmate. Another punishment was a darkened cell. A prisoner was simply shoved in a dungeon with no light, no food, and no water. Time in a cell depended on the severity of the trespass, or how much the guards didn't like you. The main business of Sing Sing was not corporal punishment, however, but production. The biggest steel mill in the country at the time had about 1,000 employees. With over 1,200 convict laborers, Sing Sing was the largest factory in the United States, and possibly the world. Prisoners silently worked 10-hour shifts in a local quarry, but production was not just limited to the extraction of marble. Convicts produced boots, hats, barrels, carpets, brushes, and even parts of sophisticated machinery such as boilers. There were no visitations allowed, not even a letter could be received. You weren't even allowed to sing at Sing Sing. Despite how horrible this sound, Sing Sing was viewed as a model prison because it turned out a profit immediately. The marble Sing Sing prisoners mine were used for notable buildings such as NYU, Grace Church in Manhattan, and the New York State Capitol building in Albany. Little did they know, but this was the infancy of what would become a huge business complex. The Auburn system would be nationally adopted and become known as the New York system. Many companies would also become hooked to this cheap prison labor. So the next time you hear about the prison industrial complex, just remember it all started at Sing Sing. Sing Sing made history in other ways. The first women penitentiary was opened there in 1839. It was called Mount Pleasant Female Prison. There was apparently nothing pleasant about that place. A Sing Sing chaplain named John Lucky described in his book, Prison Sketches, the tale of a female inmate gone insane. When released, she wandered the streets of New York with her Bible in one hand and shoes in the other. The female prison wing of Sing Sing was considered a failed experiment and closed in 1877. 11 years later, in 1888, New York State was in search of a more humane method of execution. As a result, Governor Daniel Hill signed a bill authorizing the use of the electric chair, because you know, frying you to death is more humane than the rope. It is important to note here that New York was the first state to adopt the electric chair in the entire country, and it didn't take long for Sing Sing to turn this legislation into action. Sing Sing got its electric chair in 1890. They named it Old Sparky. On July 17, 1891, Harris Smaller was the first person executed by the electric chair at Sing Sing. Four other prisoners were also executed that same day. Electric chair executions had a schedule, 11 p.m. at night, every Thursday. Old Sparky apparently had a long career in Sing Sing, frying 614 people, 8 of which were women. What I find interesting, and even borderline sadistic, is that the staff went out of their way to make sure prisoners did not escape the electric chair, placing all sorts of measures to prevent the death row inmate from committing suicide. There are even instances of staff surgeons performing a diligent operation to rescue an inmate that poisoned himself. There was no cheating the electric chair at Sing Sing. You had to see Old Sparky. Famous victims included Francis Two Gun Crowley and Julius and Ethel Rosenberg, a civilian couple who were found guilty of providing atomic secrets to the Soviet Union. In 1972, the US Supreme Court ruled the death penalty as unconstitutional due to the fact that its application was inconsistent and arbitrary. Old Sparky was then transferred to the Green Haven Correctional Facility and never used again. You probably think Sing Sing is something of a nightmare, and it was. But to be fair, I must say that the prison has also shown progressive reforms. Lockstep was abolished in 1900. Striped uniforms were also gone 4 years later. Inmates were gradually permitted freedom such as speaking, and recreational activities such as baseball for inmates were also introduced in 1930. Legend has it that Babe Ruth apparently hit his longest home run in an exhibition game against the Sing Sing baseball team, the Black Sheep. I kind of like that name. Sing Sing is also the cultural birthplace of terms like the last mile, which referred to the final trip for the electric chair. It also spawned the term up the river, or up north, which means going to prison. Many people think this saying has roots in hip-hop, but the term far predates it. Remember, Sing Sing was built in 1825. America was just 49 years old at the time. As we speak, there are initiatives to turn a part of Sing Sing prison into a museum. Its close proximity to the city makes it an ideal attraction for millions of New Yorkers and tourists alike. Oddly enough, I actually think this is a good idea. Not because I like prisons, but because our children need to witness the collective insanity that once plagued society. The process of turning a portion of Sing Sing into a museum is still in the works. However, those of you who want an experience now can visit the smaller prison museum that is already operating on Main Street. I am not an expert in crime and punishment, but the idea of rehabilitating someone by plunging them in abnormally harsh conditions makes no sense to me. Humans of the future will have a morality far superior than ours. I'm certain that they will come up with far better solutions to crimes than what we currently have. I once read in a book by Nikola Tesla that humanity is a single organism. If that statement is true, then these so-called criminals are just different versions of myself, just like I am a different version of you. Although not always guiltless, I sincerely believe that most prisoners are just misunderstood. We should really ask ourselves, how did they become that way? I'm sure their story would dissolve many barriers. As we learn to communicate better as people, crimes will decline. Until then, we can do our part by listening more and judging less. See you next time.